Bourbon whiskey is uniquely American. The U.S. Congress officially recognized it as a product distinct to the nation. This amber-hued brew was first cooked up by Scottish and Irish settlers in late 18th century Kentucky. Today, production continues there with the approval of Congress. The American government regulates the making of bourbon to keep this native spirit true to tradition. By law, it must be made from a grain mix that's at least 51% corn. Distillers often use more for flavor. Shakers sift out cobs or other foreign material, and the kernels head into a grinder. Inside, rollers crush the kernels to release the flavor of the starch. The process leaves larger chunks of the corn germ and husks. Once distilled, these bits will settle out. In separate batches, the machine also grinds malted barley and soft red winter wheat. They cook the corn and blend it with limestone-rich, iron-free Kentucky water. They add the barley, winter wheat, and a bit of mash from a previous batch. Along with a special yeast formulation, the grain mash flows into fermentation tanks made of cypress wood. After 8 to 10 hours, the yeast works its magic, and the mash becomes a bubbling brew. The bubbling is caused by the release of carbon dioxide gas as the grain sugars ferment and become alcohol. After 3 days, it has fermented into a thick liquid they call distiller's beer. They pump it into a column still, which boils off the alcohol, leaving water and other substances behind. The alcoholic vapor rises up to be condensed into liquid. After distilling it a second time, the alcohol concentration rises to a strong 130 proof. It's clear with no noticeable color. At this stage, they call it White Dog. Once water has been added to dilute the whiskey to 110 proof, an employee takes a sample and sends it to the lab. There, a technician places a test tube of the alcohol into a gas chromatograph tester. It vaporizes the alcohol and then analyzes the flavor compounds and alcohol strength. With approval from the lab, they're ready to barrel the batch. They pump it out of storage tanks and into new oak barrels that have been purposely charred on the inside. Charring caramelizes naturally occurring wood sugars to add sweetness to the alcohol as it ages. It will also turn the clear alcohol an amber color. Once corked with a walnut stopper, the employee rolls the barrel into a multi-tiered warehouse. Here, the bourbon will age for many years. Partway through, they'll move the barrel to another level of the building due to temperature variations. This will make the product more consistent. After 6 to 7 years, they uncork the stopper and insert steel tubes to draw in ambient air. This causes the bourbon to flow freely when tipped, and it gushes into a trough. The alcohol has ripened to a sweet caramel-colored brew. After they add more water to make it 90 proof, it's ready for bottling. Nozzles fill the bottles with bourbon right to the neck. The bottles then circle over to the cap applicators. The applicators spin metal caps, screwing them onto the bottles. The bottles then ride a carousel, and a device picks up and applies the labels. A brush smooths them to the bottles. Down the line, a two-person team retrieves the bottles and dips the caps in hot wax. The wax quickly dries and solidifies to give the bourbon a better seal. After several years in the distillery, this Kentucky bourbon has come of age, and that calls for a toast.